I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
Piling up.
I have mad respect for the way he challenges and the way Errol and Jermell Charlo train after watching that for 4 days. That was unbelievable.
Derrick, wow. Derrick, listen, you've been awarded the 2017 Trainer of the Year by Ring Magazine as well as Yahoo Sports. What do you feel, you know, without you being modest, makes you great as a trainer?
That I don't think about that anymore. I think that it's something that, hypothetically, if you could possibly do it, you say, I want to do it. So I've done it. So I let it go. And I don't worry about it. Because my key is to make sure my guys look good, my guys keep getting better, my guys keep growing. And you notice a lot of guys who win those awards, right? They take on 25 fighters. The fighters that they had before don't do that well. And or they don't talk about them anymore. So my thing is that I'm not so involved in about the awards and accolades, because there is no accolade greater than my guys winning and being successful. So I have to keep pushing it.
My follow-up question to you is, you know, now that you, you know, everybody notices your work, everybody notices the champions that you have, the sport of boxing is always buzzing, especially here in Dallas. Who has inspired you as a trainer, whether they be active or non-active, as far as legendary trainers?
Well, you know, I've been inspired by my boxing coach. I think nobody... The two older guys that inspired me the most, I think, my boxing coach, Taylor August, and also I like Nacho Beristáin. So I mean, I don't watch him, but I think it's just focus, his discipline, his technique, and how he gets those guys, and he pushes those guys to be great. His ability to teach counterpunching, teach so much defense, that's great for me to see. My coach is exactly the same way. So those are the two guys who are older guys, motivate and inspire me. And also, I was sitting down one day, Errol and I were sitting with Curtis Coates, and Errol's father asked him, he said, what is the difference between boxing today and boxing and you fighting? He said, there are no teachers in boxing. So if you think about it, most trainers are not teaching, they're working guys out. So the guys in good shape, but the technique and skill are lacking. I don't believe in it. Like guys say, yeah, it's good team. I think that's BS. The guy hits you with a bad punch. If you rotate your whole body on the punch, there's no way your body can take that type of pressure. So it's a bad punch, not a good chin.
As a trainer, when you go into training camp, especially with, you know, superior athletes that you have, I mean, do you as a trainer try and work on new things from the previous fights, or if it's something that you see in the training camp that you feel that you want to work on, or is it just something repetitive?
I mean, well, first of all, I think we have to address the initial issue that they had in the first fight.
Okay.
If it was the issue in the first fight, the fight before, then it's going to carry over to each fight. So I first have to address the first issue of whatever it was going wrong in the first fight. Then come up to whatever new and build and grow from that point. And I think that you constantly keep going and building a big hole. You're going to take those holes with you. Somebody's going to eventually be able to fill it. So I think you have to constantly keep refilling the holes and keep getting better and better and better.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.